In this quick tip video, I'm going to show you how to set up a submix, or a mix bus as it's also called. I'll quickly show you how to set it up and talk a little bit about the advantages of using them. I've been asked a lot about submixes or mix buses lately. There seems to be some confusion out there about this, so today I'm going to try and clear that up. A submix is a mixer track that has other tracks routed to it. There will typically be various collections of tracks routed to individual submixes within a project. For example, all of your drums and percussive elements might be routed to one submix, and all your bass elements to another, and so on. There are several advantages of grouping your tracks together this way. One of the most obvious is that by sending groups of tracks to a bus, you can process all those individual tracks as a whole on the submix itself. This is quite useful when you want to apply filtering on your drums at the same time, for example. Otherwise, you would have to do this for every single element one by one. If you know you're going to use the same reverb, delay, sidechain, or whatever on all your elements, you might as well then do it on the submix instead. A lot of producers like to use compression on their submixes in order to glue their sounds together. There are even dedicated mix bus compressors out there that you can buy, which is supposed to be specially designed for use on submixes, so-called glue compressors or mix bus compressors. Setting up a submix in FL Studio is actually very simple. Here we have some drums going to four mixer tracks. Now, let's make a submix. The first thing we need to do is make sure that there is an empty track to the right of the last drum track. If you don't have that, then just select an empty track and move it sideways within the mixer by holding down the Alt key while at the same time using the left or right arrows on your keyboard. Now that we have an empty track to the right of our four drum tracks, make sure to select all the tracks you want to be included in the submix, including the empty track. To do this, hold down the Ctrl key on your keyboard and then drag with your mouse to select all the tracks. Right-click here on the empty track, select Track Routing, and then Create Submix. Let's give it a proper name. You can also give it a symbol if you like. It's important to stay organized. We can also add a separator to make it stand out from the rest of the tracks. As you can see, the tracks have now been disconnected from the master and routed to the submix instead. You can of course do this manually too, simply unroute the track from the master and then route it to the submix instead, like this. You might have to do that later on if you want to add more tracks to the submix. Now we can apply effects to the submix. Any effect you add here will now affect all the tracks routed to the submix. You can, of course, also apply effects to the individual tracks within the submix to better control the individual elements within it. If I wanted to filter all my drums at the same time, for example, I can now do that by adding a filter to the submix and then create an automation clip. This just makes everything so much more convenient. In the long run, this will save you a lot of time. Here's another example. Here we have some pads going on. They all have individual processing, but they still go to a pad submix. On this submix, we have some compression going on in order to glue the sounds together, as well as some saturation to add warmness. We also have a tape stop effect and a filter, which is automated throughout the track. By doing it this way, I get away with using just 2 automation clips instead of 8.
An unidentified object from outer space. Alien life forms. Alien life forms. Alien life forms.
I hope this was helpful. If you liked the video, then give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet, then make sure to hit that subscribe button so that you'll get notified the next time I upload a video. I'd like to thank my Patreons who help make these videos possible. If you'd like to see more videos like this, then you can head over there to Patreon and donate. As always, if there's any specific tutorial you'd like me to make, or if you have a question, just let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching.